Some of you may have seen the video of that I made for the Lamy Safari. It's proven to be a very good pen, and I've really enjoyed it. This is the box that it came in, as some of you probably remember seeing in the video that I made. But in today's video, I've bought another Lamy product. I thought I'd show it to you. This will actually be the first time that I've looked at it myself. This pen is the Lamy Al-Star. And as you can see, it's very much like a Safari. But there are some differences, and that's what I'm going to talk about. Now, Lamy introduced the All-Star in 1997, which was 17 years after they introduced the Safari. So, you know, almost two decades went by before the All-Star came out. Now, this pen is made of aluminum. And much like the Safari, the All-Star has a modern, high-tech look and feel to it. And even though the pen is fairly large, it's very light in the hand, and I guess that's because of its aluminum construction. Lamy says that they picked this material so as to associate the pen with modern high-tech industries. Now the All-Star, much like the Safari, has a ink level window in the barrel. And the pen works with either a cartridge or a converter. It also has a transparent ergonomic grip section, and it has sculpted finger pads. And that makes the pen comfortable to hold. And like I said, the section is transparent. And I can actually see the fins of the collector through the smoke-colored transparent plastic. I'm not sure if you can see it on the video. And this nib is made of stainless steel. But you can get it in a black chromium plated stainless steel, like I did when I purchased the Safari. Is made of a brass, or what they call a spring brass wire. The Safari was designed to go after the youth market, to get them acquainted with high-quality writing instruments, and then hopefully pulling them up into the higher models of pens. I believe that I read that the Safari was not launched as a school pen, but a cool pen. And it is pretty cool. But the All-Star, even though it was designed and launched 17 years after the Safari, this pen was made to be very durable. Now the color of this pen, I think, is called Ocean Blue. It's a very pretty blue. It's very nice. And it looks like much thought was put into the design elements, even the shape of the barrel, which it has these kind of flat sides, and that's so that the pin won't roll off of a flat surface and plunge to the floor, thus bending the nib. And of course you have the ink windows. Which would make it easy to monitor the ink. And this clip was created so that the pen would easily adapt to the clothes of the user. And because this is such a cool pen, the user may not be wearing a traditional business shirt. They might have a sweater on, some type of a pullover. And it came with an ink cartridge. In this piece of cardboard, this little round piece of cardboard is put in place to keep the barrel from being screwed down too far, because if you do that, it'll puncture the cartridge. Now when capped, this pen is almost 5.5 inches long. 5 inches, 480 thousandths to be exact. And when posted, the pen actually exceeds the range of my caliper. But I did read that it was 6 5/8 inches when posted. Let's just see. Yeah, 6 5/8. The finish on this pen is a polished matte finish. And because it's aluminum, it's kind of cool to the touch. Cap post. It's very, very securely, actually. It's kind of impressed by that. And like I mentioned, the suction grip fits the hand just where the fingers need to be. Now the Lamy cartridges, well, they're very long, and they're not available just anywhere, so I opted to purchase my All-Star with a converter. This is the Lamy Z24 converter, and it does add a few dollars to the price of the pen, but it's well worth it in my opinion, just so that you can use a variety of inks. It seems to be a very smooth operating converter. And it locks into the section very securely. The cap is not a screw-on cap, it's a snap cap. But it's not too hard to put on or too hard to take off like some of the inexpensive Chinese pens. Let's see how much it weighs. Okay, in ounces it weighs 0.7. And in grams, it weighs 22. Let's see how that compares to the Safari. Grams for the Safari. 0.6 ounces. So the All-Star is a bit heavier, and I guess because it's made out of metal. What do you say we ink it up? I have some Noodler's Baystate Blue. I thought the color would go well with the color of the pen. I've never used this ink before. So after I use it, after we write with it a little bit, I'll talk about this ink some. That's beautiful. Let's see if I can keep from spilling it all over my desk. I'll go down and force the air out of the converter. And then I'll go up drawing the ink into it. This nib is not a normal nib. It's flat on the end. And it's 1.5 millimeters across from the width of the nib. It's what they call an italic nib. And believe it or not, this is my, I think it's my first italic nib fountain pen. So I'm anxious to see how that's going to write. But before we write, let's see what else is in the box. Actually, that's all just a warranty policy. Well, here goes nothing. That's pretty nice. I think I'll reposition the camera to give you a closer look at the paper in the ink. That's pretty sweet. You see the italic nib? Because it's so wide, it gives you quite a bit of line variation in the width of the line. Whereas the extra fine nib of the Safari, it doesn't matter if you're doing an upstroke or a downstroke or a side stroke, it's the same width all the way around. Now, the Al-Star was designed by a man named Wolfgang. Fabian, or is it Fabian? I'm not sure. And Wolfgang Fabian was born in 1943. And he was a goldsmith before studying industrial design. Mr. Fabian was also the designer of the following Lamy pens. The Lamy Agenda. The Lamy All-Star, the Lamy logo, the Lamy pickup. The Lamy Safari. The Lamy Spirit. As well as the Lamy Swift. And the Lamy Tipo, or Typo, or I'm not sure how they pronounce it. So I would say Wolfgang Fabian did a splendid job with his pen. Excuse me while I take a drink. So the pen is fantastic. So let's talk about the ink. It's a Noodler's ink. And it's called Baystate Blue. Now, the Noodler's website says that the color of this ink is a replica of a replica. And what that means is this. at the end of World War II, a colonial style blue ink was made in Boston, Massachusetts. And I don't know who made it, and Noodler's, they don't say who made it either. But the ink that they made was a replicated ink color from the colonial era, but thanks to more modern components, the ink wasn't of the acid type that was used a couple of hundred years earlier. So, I imagine it was the cobalt blue color of the colonial era original that led someone to replicate it about 70 years ago. And this wonderfully intense color can still be had in this Noodler's ink. And unlike the original, this Noodler's version avoids the acidity of the earlier inks. And in addition, it's waterproof once it's dry. I am not a paid spokesman for Noodler's. They have no idea that I'm even making this video. I just like their inks. I've grown to love the artwork that Noodler's puts on their labels. And this particular label is as unique and interesting as the rest. It depicts two giant catfish spitting ink upon the golden dome of the Massachusetts state capitol. Now, Noodler says that they leave the meaning of the artwork free for interpretation, but throws in the reminder that there was once a little thing called the Tea Party, once upon a time. I pulled the pen just a little too fast and it skipped. The Noodler's, they said that their hope with a Baystate blue is that when you place the pen to the page, that this color jumps out before your eyes with that same vibrancy of the rebellious inks that King George so vehemently disliked. So based on what I'm seeing before me right now, I'd say that if good old King George were somehow sitting right next to me right now, at this very moment, he'd snatch up this bottle of ink and throw it against my wall. It's a beautiful pen. It's a beautiful color. And the ink is every bit as beautiful. And I'm really digging this italic nib. So I'm really going to enjoy this quite a bit. After this video, I'll probably play around with it for at least an hour. So, thanks for watching.